Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Katelyn, and today we are doing another double name monster mash. So first off, before we get started, I just wanted to do a quick plug for my Kickstarter that just went live earlier this week. What the Kickstarter is for is I am creating my own monster manual. Basically, I'm creating a book filled with my own original creatures, ranging from ones from monster mashes to ones you haven't seen before that you can just drop into your Dungeons & Dragons game or Pathfinder or any other role-playing game. So if you guys want to pick up a copy of the book or check out the Kickstarter, the link is in the description below, and the monster we are creating today will also be present in the Creature Compendium. So feel free to check out the Kickstarter, the link is in the description below, and it will be running until August 4th at 9 a.m. Mountain Standard Time. That is the final time, the cutoff, just as a heads up. So I'm also going to be doing a lot of exclusive live streams over on my Twitch, which is twitch.tv/KMcCaigue, and we're going to be doing some creature creation and then some live D&D sessions to show off the creatures. So make sure to check out my Twitch channel to see the full schedule. All right, so let's go ahead and jump in and start making the new monster today. All right, guys, so we are back with our trusty list of double animal names. So what I'm going to do is grab a random number generator and see which one from this list we're going to be drawing today. So there are 57 possibilities on this list, so let's see what we get. 31. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. All right, so for 31, we got the owl monkey. I am so excited because I've actually sketched something like this before and I love this combo. So I'm actually really excited to finally make a digital piece and make the actual creature. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and jump into this. I'm gonna do a couple of rough sketches to try to figure out how to combine these two creatures, and then we'll pick a design, do the line art, do the color, and then we will be done. I'll see you guys in a little bit. Alright guys, so I have finished the rough sketches and I'm really gravitating towards this first one. It's a similar design to what I've done in the past. I did a couple tweaks and I've always really liked this look. It kind of reminds me of like the owlbears from D&D, and I really like this one. These other two, I still really like. This bottom one underneath the pick kind of reminds me of a creature that would be like in a Lovecraft book. It's just this weird bird with like a monkey face and a tail. I think that would be fun to play around maybe in a future episode. And then this one just reminds me of the monkeys from like Wizard of Oz, just the flying evil monkey things. So while I do like all three designs, I think I'm gonna go ahead and go with this first one. I really like it. I just really gravitate towards that one. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump in. We'll put them in a really interesting and different pose, add some color, and then we will be done. I'll see you guys in a bit. So I was super, super excited to jump in and start this piece because I've actually been wanting to draw the owl monkey for so long. Like, I've done a couple of rough sketches of what I've created in my mind and in my sketchbook, and he even made it onto the Creature Compendium cover, which I think I mentioned later in this episode. But I really love the design that I created, and I was really excited to actually put it in a digital piece and bring some more life and color and just personality to these creatures. So first off, I started with a much more dynamic pose. I really wanted to show off that obviously it's a monkey and more monkey-ish. So I wanted to put it in a cool pose in a tree, and I love how the pose turned out. I was super proud of it. And then I just jumped in after that and did the line work and started to build the shape of the character overall. And this was also, I think, well, the color was really fun. I loved coloring this one. Like, I stepped away from digital art for a little while and came back, and this just turned out really good. Like, sometimes I just need a little bit, like a bit of a break to refresh, and then once I take that break and come back, for some reason my art can sometimes turn out better. Not always, but when it does, it's amazing. So I had so much fun. And going back to what I was saying, the line art was super fun because yes, I had the sketch, but with this one specifically, I kind of added all these extra little details, or like tried to really push the overall character and caricature of this, like by adding the extra like nails, like talon-like nails to the monkey hands and feet. and then just adding the little tufts of fur. And then I also, for once, had a lot of fun drawing and creating this tree branch. And I think I'm starting to learn that I seem to perform better when I use reference, which is something that seems so simple and easy, but for the longest time I just didn't really want to do. And it helped a lot, especially with the tree branch, because I've told you guys, I've always struggled with, I guess, painting backgrounds or more nature-y things, because I always feel they don't look very natural whenever I paint them. But this one, I was very happy with it, because I'm like, wow, look, I can actually paint wood for once. Wow. And I mean, honestly, what did happen was I observed the tree branch photo that I was referencing. I looked at where the different colors were placed on the wood and how the whole thing was structured, and basically just color placement and how the different colors on the branch interacted with each other, and it came out very successfully. I was super happy with it. And then I also had a bunch of fun coloring and texturing the owl monkey. I feel this guy came back to how I painted the Nargacuga. Like, I feel I finally got back into that type of painting habit, specifically with this one. And I was so happy, because I did that Nargacuga one and I loved it, but I, for some reason, couldn't nail that coloring again. And I just, this whole thing I love. I really, really like how it turned out, the coloring, the shading, everything. And I know most of this voiceover, I was just gushing about it, and I'm about to gush about it more in the end, but it was still an amazing piece to work on. It was super fun, and I hope you guys liked it, because, it's so cool, and I love it so, so much. All right, guys, I am all done with this piece, and I don't have words. I am so, so happy with this one. I actually stepped away from doing digital art for a couple of weeks to kind of like refresh and get my brain reset, and then VidCon and like getting the Kickstarter ready. And I am really glad I stepped away, because I feel sometimes I come back and I make something even better. I am super happy with this piece. I really like how the colors came out. I really pushed the pose, and I really, really love how the whole thing turned out overall. And this was a really fun creature to do. I've doodled him here and there, and actually, fun fact, a baby version of it is on the cover of the Creature Compendium. And I haven't really done a full illustrative piece of this type of creature, and guys, I love it. I love it so much, and I know I'm gushing, and I'm not giving you like a bunch of cool information about this piece, but I can't get over how much I like this one. So just to wrap it up, this was a combination of an owl and a monkey to make an owl monkey, and I used kind of some elements from a barn owl, and I also kind of pulled in some great horned owl bits, and then I used the spider monkey as the monkey part of this, and I really wanted to try something different with the colors. Like, I could have followed the colors of the animals, but I've just seen this as like a dark, maybe more like cryptic creature, so I wanted to give it like this purplish fur and skin, and with the orange eyes, I just love it. I love it, I love it, I love it, and I'm so happy with this piece. So I hope you guys like this episode, and if you aren't already, make sure to check out the Creature Compendium. I have the Kickstarter link down in the description below. I would really appreciate your support. This has kind of been my little baby project I've been working on for a while, and I am really excited to put this monster in that book. And just a reminder, it runs until August 4th, 2018, so make sure to get on that, especially because there's some limited deals on the Kickstarter. So thanks again, guys, so much for stopping by and checking out this video. And if you aren't already, you can go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I have new videos every week, ranging from monster mashes to art challenges to just having fun with art, because that's what I love to do. And if you like this video, I love if you left a like down below, and let me know what you think. Leave me a comment. What do you think of this creature? Do you think I did a pretty decent job, or would you have done something a little different? So thanks again, guys, so much for stopping by, and I will see you all next time. Bye, everybody.